The coronavirus pandemic has changed the list of school supplies for students. In addition to face masks, students heading back to class at Clearwater Central Catholic High School on August 24th will have their own desk shields.
Obviously, our goal right now is to make these available for all students.
The three-sided shields will be assigned to each student. The protective barriers will also be placed around teachers' desks.
You see, I have a shield that is protecting, allows the students to see my face. And then I have a shield in front of me, so I'm not set at my desk. I'm not stuck at my desk. I can move around a little bit.
Other safety measures include face shields, regular cleaning and sanitizing, on-site temperature checks, and on-site COVID testing for faculty and staff.
They will see lots of supervision in the hallways like they've never seen it before. Why? To keep them safe. They will see four classes a day rather than seven. Different kind of schedule, and that schedule will allow for less transition, therefore better supervision, and therefore more safety for the students.
According to Principal James Deputy, a majority of the school's parents have expressed that with current safety measures in place, they're comfortable sending their child back into the classroom this fall.
We asked our parents to participate in a letter of intent of what their desire was moving forward at the school, and I can tell you with almost about 100% polling results in right now, we have about 87% of our parents that have chosen in school.
And for Clearwater Central Catholic parents who are choosing distance learning.
And so I use Zoom.
Teachers like Gabrielle Noyce are adapting their lesson plans to meet their needs.
Home, I'll always leave my video on there so they can actually see me on their video as well. And then I use my iPad as my whiteboard.
The school is also opening additional wings this fall, meaning more space for students to spread out. For Clearwater Central Catholic's full reopening plan, head to the WFLA app. In Pinellas County, Serafina Brooks, 8 on your side.